go to Warren for a stock market update and a company call from the Ayala trading floor. Warren?
Thanks, Ron. Taking a look at the market right now, it is trading at a new record high again. The PSEI new intraday high is 5648.34. Right now, it's at 5646.93, up about a quarter of a percent or 13 points, building on the momentum from yesterday and that fantastic GDP growth report of 7.1%. But the value turnover is still in the early goings, but right now it's just 700 million pesos worth of shares changing hands so far. Time now for our company call. We are joined by the Chief Financial Officer of Meralco, Ms. Betty C. Yap. Good morning.
Hi, good morning, Warren.
Thank you so much for joining us, and congratulations on the credit rating upgrade from Standard & Poor's.
Thank you, and thank you for having Meralco here.
All right, let's get right into it. Let's discuss first your nine-month financial results. Revenues up 14% year-on-year. Where is the growth coming from?
Okay. First, if you look at it, in general, we are being buoyed by a very resilient economy, buoyant economy driven by domestic consumption. In general, we have seen increases across all our three customer classes, the industrial, residential, and commercial. For the industrial customers, they are driven by the semiconductor industry, food and beverage, the non-metallic, and construction, general construction for real estate. For the commercial sector, this is largely driven by real estate, which is the BPO services, commercial, the commercial centers, malls, and the recent addition would be Entertainment City. With respect to our residential customers, it's partly driven by the very benign inflation, so there's more share in the wallet as far as Meralco is concerned, and the temperature. A large factor in terms of residential customers would be the temperature.
All right, I do believe we do have a slide for that, actually showing the breakdown of the share in your in growth from in residential, industrial, and commercial areas. Let's talk about your bottom line. Your profit attributable to equity shareholders up 37% year on year to 13 billion. Your core income up 11% year on year. Pretty good profit figures there.
Yes, our core net income basically would be our run rate. So that's if we back out anything that is one time. With respect to our reported net income, which is higher, that's largely driven by number one, the really relevant number there would be our volume. Volume has driven our bottom line. Second would be during the year, we actually had a recovery of local franchise tax, which was approved by the ERC sometime in May of this year. And these were actually taxes that we have paid in prior years that we're only allowed to recover right now. And we had a one-time gain with respect to our disposal of investment in Rockwell Land.
And actually, yes, from the Rockwell Land shares,
yes.
Exactly. You've actually raised profit targets twice this year, so you weren't really expecting this strong growth.
Yes, our chairman, Mr. Manuel Pangilinan, has upped our guidance to 16 billion by year end. We hope to make our targets. We're very confident and optimistic with the way the economy is going on right now.
All right, let's talk about sustaining this into 2013. You have a capital expenditure set for at 11 billion pesos for next year from about 9 billion this year. Where is that money going to go into? I know you're going to roll out that prepaid energy system. Let's talk about that.
Okay. Yes, we do have a capital commitment of 11 billion. Actually, for the whole regulatory period, that would be from July of 2011 until June of 2015. That's a total of 36 billion. We expect to do about 11 billion next year, largely for our distribution network to ensure that we have a very robust network to cover our expected customer count growth as well as the load growth. Separately, we're also rolling out prepaid electricity. The idea really of prepaid electricity is for us to be able to empower our consumers with respect and putting more into their hands so that they will be able to manage their electricity spend. At the end of the day, we want to avoid bill shocks, and the experience would be similar to a mobile phone prepaid user, except that we would require our customers to go to a Meralco branch to apply for prepaid electricity. But after that, the top-up experience would be the same. We'll have denominations of 100, 200, 500, and 1,000. And what we intend to do is we will be talking with all the telcos so that what's going to happen is we will be informing or sending a text message to the customer who is on prepaid when they are down to a 3-day load value.
And it also helps be part of the PLDT group. Talking about the smart grid that you need to have in place for this system to work, how big will the initial area where this service will be available?
The initial approval of ERC up to June of 2015 would be 40,000 meters. We will be rolling out a few because what we intend to do is to have a technical pilot in the first quarter of 2013 and a commercial pilot in the third quarter. Okay, so that would be a few customers first. The area that we've chosen would be Angono. Yes.
Okay, you did mention helping to manage the cost of your customers, but another way you want to help them with this is through entering the generation business. Let's talk a bit about your entry into that sector. How is that going along? How's the time frame?
Okay. As some people would know, no, Meralco was originally vertically integrated, which means we had power generation until those assets were sold to the government. But right now, there's been, if you look at the DOE supply and demand outlook, the general view is there's going to be tightness in supply through probably 2015 or 2016. And what Meralco would like to do is to be part of the solution. So our first more concrete project would be a 2x300 power plant at the Subic zone. This is we expect this to be on stream by the first half of 2016. The reason that we'd like to go into power generation is because we'd like to help contain the generation cost, which is part of the power bill, which is really Meralco's compelling commitment to public interest.
Right. There was a little bit of controversy with regards to that power plant, with the people locators there saying that they wouldn't want a power plant there. Mm-hmm. But I'm sure that we already have had this ironed out already, and you expect it to come on stream in 2016?
We're addressing it. We've been issued the ECC. We're at that stage we're in. We are ready to progress or proceed with the next steps. Now which includes identifying our equipment supplier and the ECP contractor.
Okay, so it looks like everything's going according to plan. Last question I have for you is, what's your outlook right now on power rates? Something, you know, the majority of the public wouldn't always want to know about.
Okay, usually at this time of the year, you know, towards the end of the year, power rates are generally lower because the demand has actually come down and temperatures are cooler. In fact, we had a release recently that December's power purchase rate would be lower. And also, our purchase from the WESM is actually much lower. But moving on to 2013, we actually have contracted new power sales agreement with the IPPs, and this would be on stream once the ERC approves the power rates. And we're proud to say that we've been able to contract this at very competitive prices, which would actually redound to the benefit of the consumers. Maybe the other thing also is on the operation side, we've been very successful in containing system loss charges, which also would be a benefit to our consumers. Cumulative since 2008, we've saved the consumer a total of more than 5 billion pesos.
And will your customers be able to feel all of this in their bills by this month, or?
For the December rate, they will be able to fill it in the December bill. The system loss has been there, much lower charge since 2008. For the purchase power contracts that we have signed, as soon as the ERC approves it, then it will take effect.
Okay, great news there for all the power users here in Metro Manila. Thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thank you, Warren. Yes,